Hello everyone, welcome to part 8 of my Civilization 5 playthrough here. We're returning on turn 704. Remember, this is a marathon pace on a huge map. We're in the middle part of the game where things tend to get a little bit tedious with just basically getting on with things, especially since I'm not currently fighting any wars. Depending on the map layout and where your neighbors are, by this time you often end up fighting a war at least once. My allergies are still acting up, as they have been for the past few parts, so there may be a few dead spots where the sound goes away, simply because nobody likes listening to someone sneezing and blowing their nose. Anyway, let's get on with the game here. So, if you didn't watch the first parts, I rolled Korea as my civilization. And I got an amazingly good location on a Pangaea map. Basically, there's just a single narrow land bridge blocked by city-states. And that meant I didn't have to compete for any of the ancient ruins in the immediate area of my capital. Nor did I have to compete for the land that I end up settling. Okay, Kamehameha wants to keep the open borders. Yeah, I'll let that one continue. He's far enough away that it's not going to make any difference whatsoever. Let's see. So I got 12 terms left for printing press. I have met all the other civilizations, so I think as soon as I succeed in researching printing press, the World Congress will happen. Now I'm sending my scout out there just to see if there's any barbarians that I need to deal with. Okay, this is right. I was improving the tiles there. Now, I cleared up a barbarian here, so I'll heal my swordsman. Now, if I was playing on a standard size or a smaller map of some kind, there are some barbarians over here. It would take less time between turns here, the please wait stage. But I happen to like the huge maps on Marathon because it gives much more play time. Okay, I'm just going to wander around over here. I know there's a camp there now. So I'll just, when this guy heals, I'll send him over there. I have 20 turns left on the Forbidden Palace. It'd be really nice if I get that. I usually don't. But I think things will set up this time, so I might. Okay, I'm going to mine that hill there because there's a lot of stuff generating production around that one. Let's see here. I've just about got everything around here improved. So I'll work on the rest of them there. So barbarians been attacking Brussels by the look of things. Okay, what can we build here? An opera house would improve culture. Harbor, I think, is aqueduct. Yes, aqueduct would be a good choice. As I've previously noted, I'm playing for science development, and that generally means you want higher population, since the science buildings all generate based on city population. Now, I could put a sawmill here, or lumber mill, but I'm actually going. What will this turns into plains? So I'm actually going to irrigate that, make a farm. Okay, there wasn't much to see over there. Okay, what can we build here? I think we want the amphitheater. I want to keep my culture production up. Okay, do some more exploration here. Remember that scout got the promotion from Mount Kilimanjaro? So that means it uses half movement on hills, and that's quite nice for exploration. Okay, I've got 5 trade routes available, so I've got one here, one here, theoretically. Yeah, one there, one there, one there, and one there. Nothing there. What can I? Well, let's get a cargo ship there. Again, remember, I'm trying to get food into my capital. It's better to do that by boat because the boat routes actually double the amount of food or production that get transferred on the trade route. That is compared to a caravan. Okay, so I have a cargo ship here, and I can't actually reach my capital yet from there. But there's no reason I shouldn't do some useful trading here. So I'm going to trade with Cape Town and get 5 gold. Okay. Now I'll send my warrior over here. Actually, that's a swordsman. Okay, so there isn't really much going on out here. As I said previously, I'm not going for the declarations of friendship. There are some benefits to doing that, notably that you can do research agreements, which give you a science boost, but I don't find those as useful as the drawbacks of the Declaration of Friendship. Okay, I've created me a worker here. As you may recall, I needed to improve the tiles around my city here. So that's a hill. That's plains. So I'll make a farm there. Okay, I made a bank here. Yeah, I'll build a temple there. I've got the policy that adds 25% to the city's gold from temples. And once you've got 8 gold there, that basically means building a temple is a wash. It costs nothing then to maintain it. I'm going to build one more worker there, so that I can really get things improved quickly. Apparently, Japan and Rome have called off their war. A few more turns on printing press. Okay, so I will make a farm there. I'm just going to park that scout, because I don't have anything useful I really want him to do. But I want to keep that one around because of the promotions it has. And I don't want to join somebody else's war, especially not one that far away. Okay, so I need to re-up that trade route there. Okay, there's the printing press. And my swordsman has arrived over here. Okay, so I'll start working on that. Okay, what to research now? Steel would be a good one. Economics. Yeah, it's not so critical. Navigation gives me the seaport. And that one starts giving me real production on my coastal cities. So I'm going to go for navigation before steel. That production on coast on water tiles is an update to the seaport that came with the mod I'm using that makes water tiles more useful. The stock Civilization 5 game basically makes water tiles completely bloody useless. And that means if you get a city that's basically coastal or on a small island, you're hamstrung. Okay, and here we go. Korea, that's us. We've discovered every civilization, and we got printing press. So that means we now control the World Congress. We're the host. So I'll work away at my barbarian here. And we have a proposal to make. Now, I'm not really ready to build the World's Fair, but that's essentially the. Let's see. That's a relatively safe one. But it's going to be 90 turns before the vote. So I have 90 turns to really get my production going, and realistically, I think that's probably good. But scholars in residence is also helpful if you're behind on science. It benefits everybody else who's behind on science, though, as well. I'm going to go for scholars in residence. Somebody else may suggest the World Fair, which I won't be upset about if they do. Okay, this is also in range. Oh, there's a barbarian over here. There's probably a camp or something over here. My empire's gone unhappy, so I'll need to deal with that. I've got Colosseums underway, I believe, so yes, so that will get sorted out soon enough. Okay, next turn I'll take that guy out. Okay, so Byzantium liked our Congress proposal. I'll check on what the other proposal is in a moment here. You can look while it's not your turn, but things often like to pop up and basically get in the way. Anyway, that clears that barbarian, so that's good. That's within three, so I'll farm that. I need to redo this trade route. Right, I was going to check on the World Congress. Banning marble. Now, we don't have marble, so that won't hurt if it happens to pass. So we'll let this guy heal. I've got some gold kicking around. I should upgrade some of these warriors. I've got a couple of them kicking around, I believe. That was one. No, that was just the one I had left. Upgrade these as well. Well, that one anyway is up to a Hwacha, which is essentially a trebuchet. The actual Hwacha itself is not a trebuchet, but that's the unit it replaces in game here. Okay, that was a Colosseum that straightens that out. Let us see here. Oh yes, the zoo goes a long way to improving happiness as well. So that will be nice. But I need to get some other stuff built up. So I'm going to build a market there. And let's see, a couple turns there for a worker. I might just get lucky and get the Forbidden Palace. Okay, so that's an aqueduct there. Oh, I've got a Colosseum in all my cities now. So that's good. What's the globe? Okay. I'm gonna go for a wonder in Pyongyang here. Which one? That one seems like a good one. Leaning Tower of Pisa. That's plus 25% great people in all cities. And a free great person, so that'll be good. Okay, so I've made a mine over here. Now I will wander up to some other tiles here. Let's see. What does Cape Town want? Sugar, huh? No, I'll come up that way. Have a swordsman there that we just upgraded. The Huacha. We don't have enough gold to upgrade the other catapult. Okay, we got another trade route to re-up here. And we have a worker over here. Right. So I'm building farms here to get the growth going in Daegu. Is that how you pronounce it? Whatever. Okay. I don't need more. Workers. So I'm actually going to, I'm going to set this one working on the Taj Mahal. If I don't get it, it's not the end of the world. I would like to get it though. And here, I need to get the growth going. So a lighthouse, get some more food out of the water tiles. And turn that into a farm, because that's grassland, right? So that'll be good for food. It's too bad you can't mine the mountains. Okay, so a farm there. Building them along the river means you get more food than you would otherwise. Until irrigation happens, until you get the right tech to have farms without fresh water. Yeah, we'll go open borders with Theodora. I should probably send out a few more settlers, fill in my land area here at some point. Just so I don't lose the territory I want to keep. Let's see, for growth, yeah, the aqueduct would be the right choice there. Oh, he really wants the truffles. But I actually would prefer to have gold for him. Well, he really wants it too. He's offering to vote in favor of our proposal, but it's still not gold. And that's still not gold. Well, he has a little bit of gold. Yeah, we'll accept that one. Okay, so that's a farm there. We got a grassland hill over there. To improve, I'll make a mine there. And we got the Forbidden Palace. That's the two extra delegates. And the reduction in unhappiness from population is actually really helpful. Okay, so that is our swordsman there is healed. I'm going to send him over the strait or gulf or bay or whatever that is. But yeah, I'll make a mine there. Ironworks is production plus 8. Globe Theater, a great writer. I'll build the ironworks first. Okay, what do we have here? Opera house or a zoo? I'll build the zoo. Since I'm going for lots of population, I really need the happiness buildings so that I don't end up with an unhappy empire. Oh, I should get a workboat out. Purchase. What do I need for a workboat? 540. Because we got pearls there. That I definitely want to improve. No, we don't want to get into a war. So I definitely want to improve the pearls there. It's outside the workable radius of the city, but improving it means I get the happiness benefit from the resource. Okay, there's one more hex there to work on. Yeah, when I get my next social policy, I'll start filling out the tradition tree to get that maxed out so that... what is this? That's planes. Okay. So that I get some better happiness results as well from that. And that will make a big difference. Okay, I have an amphitheater there. Do I have anything in range there for where a workboat would benefit? Yes, I do. I'll build a workboat there as well. Okay, that's that. Those hexes improved. Okay, one, two. These ones are also in range, so I'll work on those as well. Okay, so far so good. Okay, that's a hill. This is plains, so a farm there would be good. One, two, three. This would be a prime candidate for a pontoon bridge. Just to getting around this bay here would be a prime candidate. No, we're not going to make a declaration of friendship. If we put a pontoon bridge here, then we could build a road right across, and it opens up this area nicely. As a matter of fact, ooh, that's navigation. Okay, one, two, three. That is plains, so that's a good farm location as well. As I was saying, down around here would be a perfect location for another city. Anyway, I'll tool around here with my swordsman for a bit. Okay. Archaeology would be good, but I'm going to catch up on some older texts as well. Somebody sent a missionary in. Does that actually give me anything I can purchase here? No, it doesn't give me the other religion. Oh, yeah, it does. Now, here's the thing. Your faith from buildings and culture, the buildings that you built with faith still work even if your city can't build them anymore. So, because I can, I'm going to build the monastery. Because that's faith and culture. Since somebody helpfully spread their religion there, I might as well do that. Okay, now I'll leave that. No point trying to force my religion back in there. In enough turns, my Buddhism will reassert itself. Okay, so I'll farm that tile. I got my work boat, I'll send it out there. Improve the fish. Right. And I should build the seaport on my coastal cities just to maximize my production potential. So we'll keep on trucking along here. We're at about 35 minutes for this part. We've made it through about 30 some turns. So as you can see, it's taking longer for each turn on average. And we're not seeing anything particularly fancy out this way. I'll send my swordman over here just to clear this fog of war thing here, or this unknown territory thing. Okay, we built a lighthouse here. What to build now? Well, we have no gold production. Well, let's go for a market there. I could queue up a whole bunch of buildings into the build queue, and then I wouldn't have to select for every time something comes up. But I don't always want to keep everything. Okay, I'll keep that one the same just for the gold. Okay, do a little bit of exploring there. Okay, so that clears up that bit. So now we can see it all. I suspect there will be a barbarian encampment somewhere up here. Okay, we have an aqueduct there. I'll deal with the coastal tiles with a harbor and then a seaport there. Okay, if Brussels is under attack, it means there's barbarians over there. Ah, there's one up there. Okay. Okay, we finished steel. We'll go for gunpowder. We're a little behind on military units here. Okay, so this one will increase my happiness and production when building wonders. This, I think, will give me opera houses in my first four cities. So I'll go with that one. Our culture production is 114. Now it's 119, so it definitely did do something. Right. Okay. That's a hill, so we'll mine that. Re-up the trade route there. Explore some more up here. We have enough gold that we can upgrade to a huacha there. And what was it I wanted over here? I wanted a work boat over here. So we'll do that as well. Nice thing about Civilization 5 is you can just purchase something outright without having to change production to it. And that's actually really nice. Okay, do a little more exploring over here. We'll dig in with our huacha there and send the workboat out. Yeah, we don't want to be getting into their war. We have a market there. Now what do we want here? University seems like a good idea. I want to get my science buildings out there. Okay. Now we'll connect the pearls. Now we get the happiness from pearls, which is nice. Exploration. I went in the Box Canyon accidentally. Grassland up there. We'll do something with that. Oh, there's barbarians up there. Right. So I'll reestablish that trade route. Take the gamble that swordsman doesn't come out. Put a farm there. Okay, another farm out there. Somebody's gonna spread religion out here, I think. Actually, the Great Prophet is a decent exploration unit as well. Okay, we'll re-up with that trade route. People with the pointiest sticks. I'm down at number 8 out of 12. It looks like Japan only has one unit. So I need to get on building my military up. Definitely. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's a good tile to develop. Found some barbarians, so it's kind of what I came out here to do. Kamehameha is offering me gold. Okay. Yep, that'll do. I should be able to make relatively short work of those barbarians. Now I could send the musician elsewhere to conduct a concert tour, but I'm actually going to build a great work. Ah. Yeah, we'll return the unit to them. I thought about taking it and then just disbanding it, but I thought, yeah, you do get a diplomatic bonus boost if you return their units. Okay, so we'll farm there. It got took right away. Got took. Well, English that. Then again, most verbs don't need a different form for the past participle in past tense, so why would take need different forms to be understood? Ooh. You know what? Here we can get the Blitz promotion. That's our double attack. That sounds like a good thing to get. There we go. Oh, we'll return the unit again. Now, you don't get a double attack when it takes two movement points to move to the tile that you just conquered, so that's anyway, we'll clear that. Okay, so that was good for my swordsman out there. Okay, somebody built the Globe Theater. If Paracuti completed the Globe Theater, how can Ashurbanipal be constructing the Globe Theater? That doesn't make a lot of sense, does it? Okay, what have we got? That's a hill. Okay, yeah, there's a city there. I'm gonna take this swordsman and send it back over here next turn. We're up on 3/4 of an hour here, and we start what, turn 704, was it? Well, now we're at turn 755. Oh, we got gunpowder. This is nice. Let's see. What have we got here? One, two. This one we can improve with a farm. Now, this is a hill, but it's beside a river. Yeah, and we got a hill here, so I'm gonna make a farm on that one. Right, I said I was gonna bring this one out this way, so I'll bring it way over this way. Research. Let's see. Economics, that gives a windmill. Metallurgy is a lancer, arsenal, and the Red Fort. Metallurgy seems like a good choice. The Red Fort's kind of nice if you have to defend your cities. But more precisely, I'd rather get the Red Fort so nobody else does if I do need to attack them. Okay, so Japan has lost his lost a city. Somebody stole physics. The fact that they're stealing technologies from me means I've got some sort of a lead on some of the techs, so I'm not so far behind as I was, and that's kind of good. Oh, we got a great profit. Sigh. Okay. One, two, three. This is one that we can improve. What are we going to do with our great profit? You know what? That seems like a good spot to dump it. Okay, this is just plains. I'll make a farm there. Built an ironworks there. The Himeji Castle is actually a good one to have, and it's relatively inexpensive, so why not build it? Okay, so that's done there. One, two. So we need to go around this way now. That one is something we can improve. We'll mine that one. We'll end up mining these two as well. Okay, so it's a market there. To build, what to build, what to build. I'll work on my sea tiles on that one. Okay, what can we? Okay, yeah, right, seaport. That's where I was going on that one too. We'll build our seaport there too. We have lots of water tiles on this one. Yeah, if anyone watching thinks that things are getting boring here, I'm with you on that. This stage of the game often is. There's a lot of waiting for things to happen at this stage, especially if you're not fighting wars. Okay, so I. One, two, three, one, two. This one also is. Okay. Okay, cargo ship. We need to re-up our trade route. Now let's take a look in on Seoul, and we're up to 18 citizens, so let's see what it's doing. Right, because I've got it on production. It, well, let's see. Let's put it on the default focus and see what it does. It lengthens the build time, but it fills all of these out. And I think that's going to pay off better in the long run. Because seriously, all those unemployed citizens were not helpful. Might as well get them doing something like great person points. Cargo ship. And we'll re-up that. Ah, we're finished up there. Now I can send this guy over to this side. Do some upgrading on that guy before we go after the barbarian. Musket man. Oh, okay, we're done there. Let's work on improving things around here. Eventually, we will be able to reach Seoul from here with additional trade route range extenders, but not for a while. This is a hill, so that explains why it's just a mine that we can build. We're coming up on an hour here, so a few more turns, and probably after I deal with the barbarian there. I'll go ahead and end the part. Now, because the musket man is so much stronger than the swordsman, I'm probably going to just attack across the river. And we're up to 50 plus gold per turn here. That's pretty good. Yeah, that's not as good as it could be, but we'll definitely just attack across the river there. One more turn, that should do it there. Again, sorry, no friendship. There we go, we cleared the barbarian there. And I'm gonna send my swordsman around to Brussels and see what we can do for them. I'm pretty sure this is a real camp. That's a city-state quest, so pretty sure it's real. So I'll send the guy up there. There we have metallurgy. halfway to the next social policy. And 147 culture per turn. Okay, cargo ship. Re-up the route. Mine that. And I think I'll call this a part on turn 775. So we'll save the game here. So next time around is going to be even more of the same. Hopefully it will show further development of my army, which I will need to start working on real soon now. You want to make sure you have a strong military by the time the late mid-game to late game comes around. Otherwise, your stronger neighbors are going to invade, and you want to make sure that you can defend your cities. And that does mean unit spamming to some extent. But now that I've got a decent amount of gold going per turn, and it seems to be stable, I can actually afford to maintain a standing army. And it's time to start doing that. But anyway, I'll start doing that next time around, probably. But anyway, for now, that's the end of part 8, I believe it is. And if you've watched this long, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.